Hey guys, how's it going? And thanks for coming. I'm Nick, and this is Real Life Money, where we talk about real life and money, because you know schools aren't, so let's get started. So in this video, what we got going on is we're going to be talking about credit versus debit versus cash. So I didn't talk about banking stuff in a while, so decided you got to go back to the banking basics, fundamentals of what's going on. And a lot of people still don't understand like credit and debit on all that stuff. So I'm going to be going over quick little things of like some cons and pros for each. So let's start off with credit. Now, personally, this is my main form of payment. I use credit for anything with gas stations. If I have to buy something at the store, something online, I normally use credit. Now, for those of you guys that are interested in learning about a credit score, I did another recent video talking exactly how a credit score is calculated. I exposed what was, I think it was normally a secret. No one really knew how a credit score even was created or built or improved, but I gave you the breakdown of it. Link in the description. Now let's start off with some pros about credit cards. Well, obviously, using a credit card, you could build your credit. If you use it in the right way, something called utilization, very important, but basically don't keep large balances on your card. And if you pay it back like you should, no late payments, that could help build your credit. Now, why building your credit even matters is because one day, or eventually, maybe, you might go for a car, student loans, or mortgage for a house. So when you're presented to a lender at normally like a bank type of thing, they will look at your credit score. And the higher it is, the better rate that you could get because you're more trustworthy. Another pro for credit cards has to be used wisely, but you can get cash back on basically any credit card out there now. The lowest is probably like 1% cash back. So if you spend $100, you get $1 back. And something kind of cool, which people might not realize all the time, but when you buy something with a credit card, you don't have to pay for it immediately. You normally have like a month, like 30 days to come up with the cash so you could pay it when the bill comes. So you could keep it in your bank account to make a few cents of interest. You could use it for maybe other priorities before paying your actual credit card. Of course, you should always pay your credit card when the bill comes, but you do have that little cushion of an extra month before actually paying for whatever you buy, like that pizza. Now, the bad things of credit cards, the worst thing you could possibly be in is credit card debt. Now, you're not a bad person if you're in credit card debt. However, it's not the best situation that you should be in, guys. The interest rate for like an average credit card is like 15%. So most of the money that you pay, well, not most of it, but a large chunk of the money that you pay to these credit card companies is kind of just wasted on interest. It's not even going toward your principal. So you need to fight for your life, because it kind of depends on getting out of credit card debt, because it is destroying you. Now, another con to credit cards is that it's very, very simple to swipe. As in like, hey, look at those shoes. You swipe the card. Hey, look at that giant pizza. I want that. Anything you see, you could simply swipe the card and you don't even really mentally understand what that's costing you. So whatever the amount, if something is $10 versus $1,000, you'll still just swipe it. Because you could spend more than you actually have. One huge con about credit cards that a lot of people don't realize, we're talking about the cash back. So yeah, we said that it is a pro to get cash back. If you're going to spend money on something, might as well get something back, right? Well, studies have shown that people actually spend like 20, 30, even 40% more on getting something because they think they're getting more cash back, right? If you spend more, you save more. No, like you're spending an extra $100 just to get an extra dollar back. It doesn't make sense. So don't spend more just to get more cash back. That's not good. And that's why credit card companies offer that, by the way, because they know that a lot of people are irresponsible and will actually pay more to get cash back. So in the end, they're winning, we're not. So those are the basic pros and cons of credit cards. Of course, there are more, but those are the main ones. Moving on to a debit card. Now, for those of you who don't know what a debit card is, it is still a card like a credit card. You could swipe it wherever. But like we said before, a credit card, a bill comes in usually around a month from now. A debit card, when you swipe it, it comes straight out of your bank account. Now that might seem very unattractive, but of course there are pros and cons to that. Now one pro of having a debit card over, let's say, cash is that it's just a card. You don't have like a giant wad of cash in your pocket. You have just a card and it's linked straight to your bank account. So it's basically like carrying cash, but in the form of a card. So another pro to debit cards, kind of, and I'll go into it, but you can't always spend more than what you have. So if you are looking at shoes for $120 and your account only has $100, you have to set it up this way, but that transaction will simply not go through and you can't spend more than you have. Now the cons to debit cards is that you don't have it set up like that and you can overspend. So when your account goes negative, there are fees involved. So you're paying for something that's kind of completely avoidable. That's kind of it. Like it's, unfortunately, it is third grade math. It's nothing crazy. Like if you have $100, you can't spend more than that, but people do. And I used to work in a bank, guys. There were so many people just paying through the nose with these fees, overdraft charges, and it's just insane. So if you could just gain control even a little bit of your money, you could save a huge chunk. Now, another con to debit cards, basically the same as credit cards, that again, you mentally don't understand what you're actually paying for. It could be $10 or $1,000, you're still swiping. So that's why we're moving on to cash now. So we're talking cash, right? So you have money in your pocket, in your hand. So one of the pros to having cash is that it actually hurts to give Mr. Jackson or someone higher than him away. You actually see the bill leaving your hand and you don't like that feeling. So a lot of cases, you actually won't spend as much. Another pro to cash is that if you only have $20, you can only spend $20. You can't be spending $25. You can't be spending $100 because you only have the $20. So if you know that you're irresponsible, good for you that you actually know this, because people don't see their problems. But if you know if you're irresponsible, use cash so you simply can't overspend the money that you don't have. Now this kind of builds mental strength. It's pretty cool to see actual money in your wallet, in your pocket, wherever. Now I'll actually give a quick shout out to Nate O'Brien. He has another YouTube channel. I'll definitely link him in the description. Great person, does YouTube videos like I do, much bigger than me. But a thing that I learned while watching him, he was talking about saving money with cash. So every time that you have a single or a five, you just put it in piggy bank, a shoebox, or whatever. And it doesn't hurt to do that because it is a small denomination. So every time you have a small bill, you put it away and it grows and grows and grows without you even realizing it. So it's just kind of a small way to save money. I thought it was pretty cool.
Thanks, Nate.
Now, of course, there are some cons to cash as well. If you have a lot of it, it's not really that safe. Someone can steal it from you, unfortunately. There are dirtbags out there. Another thing, it could be an inconvenience. If you have a huge wad or a stack of bills, it's hard to fit in your wallet. You can't fit it in your pocket. I mean, that's a good thing, a good problem to have, I suppose. And another con is that you can't buy something online. You know, if you have money in front of you and you see something on the screen, you can't transport it into the screen. Now, that can be a good thing because that kind of forces you not to buy something, and in most cases, we don't need those things that we're trying to buy. So you kind of see the pros and cons of each of these things, whether it's a credit card, a debit card, or straight up cash. But if you think you're responsible of using a credit card wisely, actually building your credit, paying it off, and maybe reaping a few benefits of cash back. So some people hate credit cards, some people love credit cards, but just be responsible. So you don't have to prove that to me at all. You have to prove that to yourself if you could actually use it wisely. And that's kind of it. Kind of just want to do a quick thing of these three payment forms. If I missed anything that you think is big, definitely let me know. If you have any questions, comments, concerns, down below. So don't forget to subscribe to my channel, Real Life Money, where we talk about real life and money. I just started an Instagram account if you guys want to follow. But thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.